Darkensley came. Their destination, the Games Academy somewhere out at sea. Their mission, to become Games Plane legends and to crack the challenge of Games Master.
Master Team Championship. Now, at the beginning of the series, I said we want to make the challenges tougher. Well, me and the Games Master still think they're too soft. So we've come down deep into the caretaker's furnace room here at the Games Masters Academy for the hottest video game championship you've ever seen in your life.
Games Master presents the greatest video game championship in television history, the Games Master Team Championship. The championship consists of 27 teams picked from 5,000 applicants playing over 9 heats, 3 semi-finals and 1 grand final. Each team contains 3 players featuring platform, beat-em-up and all-round experts. Each week, 3 teams play 2 challenges for points. The team with the lowest score is eliminated whilst the remaining 2 battle it out for a place in the semi-final. The teams will be playing the newest and toughest games, many of which they've never seen before. And the competition winners, well, they'll get the Amiga CD32, the 64-bit Atari, the latest IBM PC with the real magic card, and last but not least, the Philips CD-i.
So, let the games begin!
Ah, it sounds good, doesn't it? Yes, and not only that, they also win the coveted TV title of Games Master Team Champion! Yeah! So, without further ado, let's go and meet tonight's teams. Over this way. In the red baseball caps, we've got the armchairs of Hertfordshire. Armchairs, what are your names?
I'm Sean, I'm the team captain.
Team captain?
Anthony.
Anthony.
And I'm Chris.
Chris. Okay, so how do you think the team are going to do tonight, Sean?
Well, we went to the auditions and we've seen them practicing. I think we've got the best chance.
You think you've got the best chance? Well,
oh, yeah.
Brave words, yeah. Well, there you go. All right, let's go and meet the next team, see who you're up against. Right, thank you, lads. This way. Excuse me, through here. This way. Caretaker, shuffle them back. I can't see anything. Bring me a light. I want to see these guys' faces back. Okay, what's your name?
Asad, and I'm the team captain.
Ah, you're Asad team captain?
I'm Kajit.
Kajit, yeah?
And I'm David.
David, so you hired the last team, the armchairs. Do you think you're going
to
do well?
Well, I only got 4 words to say to you, Derek, and that's we're simply the best.
Simply the best? My name's changed to Derek all of a sudden. My name's Dexter, actually. Let's go and meet the next team, because this geezer doesn't even know my name. Come on, everybody. And the final team in the green baseball caps come out are the Red Bridge Raiders. Good evening, gentlemen. So, do you want to tell us your names?
Yeah, my name's Clem and I'm the team captain.
Good man.
Anil.
Waleed.
All right, so you've heard the other 2 teams spout off. How do you think your team are going to do?
No,
you worried?
No, we can beat them with our hands down.
You're not scared?
No, not at all.
And you've got all your supporters here tonight?
Yeah.
Okay, well, good luck to you all. Now, each team captain is going to choose a player from his team to play a challenge in his or her specialist field. Let's go over to the Games Master, find out what it's going to be.
For my platform challenge, I have selected Aladdin for the Sega Mega Drive. The task is to collect as many apples as you can in 45 seconds, avoiding all the pedals on the very difficult escape level. For this challenge, I'll award 5 points to the person who collects the most apples, 2 points for the runner-up, and 0 for the loser. All that remains for me to say is, I declare the championships open.
So, the game is Aladdin. They've got 45 seconds to collect as many apples as they possibly can. Now, the armchairs of Hertfordshire have got their man, Anthony, in position. What's his form like then, Dave?
Well, Anthony just about scraped through in the audition, but he'd be advised to take his time on this one because the object is to collect things, not to race through.
Right, he's got to get as many apples as he possibly can on Aladdin. So, Anthony, start your challenge!
So off goes Anthony, jumps the chasm, that's always the tricky part, just getting over there. The things to look out for are the Aladdin's lamp in the top left-hand corner, that's his life force.
Here comes the ball!
And the apples in the bottom right-hand corner.
Run!
That's what he's got to collect in 45 seconds, as many apples as possible.
Right,
he's only got
15 seconds
at the moment. Now as he comes up this chasm, he wants to jump and get his apples.
Well,
he's doing it sideways,
well,
the best
well.
Way to
6,
get these apples.
Come on, keep going.
Right up the chasm and jump backwards, because you've got a bit of
light 25 seconds gone!
He's got 10 apples
so far. He's sleeping like a lizard.
He's doing very well, he's not died.
Look at that gazelle, like
very well.
Go on, Aladdin.
There's a load of apples through there. Come on,
he's
Aladdin,
got 10 seconds. 9.
Very well.
8.
There's a boulder out there. Run that
7,
boulder.
5.
There's more apples.
4. 3. 2.
apples. One, and that's all he's going to get. Stop the challenge! 13 apples.
Stop. So the armchair scored 13 there. Now, the turbo destructor's man, David's moving into position. 13 apples, is that going to be a tough score for him to beat, Dave?
It's a tough one to beat. He was a good platform player. I think he could do it.
Yes, well, let's hope he can. Let's find out if he's ready. I'm sure he is. David, start your challenge!
David's up to do his butt jumping that chasm. Once you're over there, you can relax just a little bit. Now, there's a boulder going to come out of the ceiling now. He's going to outrun the boulder and grab apples at the same time.
He's away, there's a genius.
It might look easy at home, but it's not.
Ooh, that was
very,
close.
Very tricky. He's doing well, he's missing a lot of apples.
Dave, 15 seconds gone.
Apples there. He's got the left of the boulder up in the sky, but he missed
picking
about
up 11. He's got score so far.
He's got 11, he's doing extremely well.
Yeah, he is.
He's going to lose the life now.
Good, man.
Okay, the boulder will be coming after him any minute.
Watch out for the big old boulder!
He's definitely going to go through.
This is early!
He's doing very, very well to the bar. This is everybody in.
He's leaving like this, and he's got 10 seconds left.
He's doing that. Oh,
it's all over. Well done. His team in pole position. Next up, we've got Waleed of the Redbridge Raiders. Waleed's obviously got everything to play for. Waleed, start your challenge!
So Waleed leaps up in the air.
He's away.
He leaps down the chasm. That's an appalling example of bad
news. Bad news for Waleed there.
We've got a hall of shame.
Yeah, I think we must have, and that's definitely going to go down as the number one spot. Okay, let's check out the scoreboard. We've got the Turbo Destructors. They came first with 14 apples. That means they've got a healthy 5 points. Following closely behind was the Armchairs from Hertfordshire. They scored 13 apples, that means they get 2 points. And the Redbridge Raiders got zilch apples, that means they got zilch points. Yeah, they've got a lot of catching up to do. Okay, we're going to set up the next challenge. While we do that, you can sit back and enjoy the reviews. One of the Amiga's top football games gets converted across to the Mega Drive. How does this affect the brilliant gameplay of Sensible?
Renegade have made a corking job of this conversion. They use the three buttons on the Sega pad to real effect and make it a game of passing, banana shots, everything basically.
There are three new levels of play, easy to expert, which means if you're new to a game, you're not going to be humiliated too often by crushing defeats. It's a wonderful game. It's the best soccer game around, anywhere, any place, anytime.
They come, they go, soccer games, that is. Sensible's going to stay. The only thing unsensible about this game is if you don't buy it.
That blonde menace, Dennis, who's always causing trouble in the movie, gets to cause trouble in his own game. Can Dennis cause a stir in over 20 levels of platform action?
Ever had the feeling of deja vu? Well, you will with this one. Dennis is another retread of the Addams Family motif as we come out collecting coins again.
The graphics are nice to look at, but the collision detection is awful.
Yeah, been there, done it, seen it, tried it, boring. Avoid it, man.
Choose between 16 international teams to see if you can do any better than England's feeble effort on the Game Boy's new game, Goal.
It's a brave move to try and bring out a football game on the Game Boy. It'd be nice to say Goal succeeded, but unfortunately, it doesn't. The graphics are confusing and blurred.
Goal is a real letdown. It's the Barnet of football games, in fact. It's terrible.
It's impossible to see where the ball is. As a result, it's a complete no-hoper from the start. Just avoid it.
Something there for everyone in the review. Okay, it's time for our teams to test their skill at another challenge. Let's go over to the Games Master, find out exactly what this challenge is going to be.
The sports sim I've selected is the exciting skiing game Val d'Isère for the Super Nintendo. The challenge is to snowboard down the twisting slalom course in the quickest time. Make sure that you ski between all the gates, as 2 seconds will be added to your time for every gate missed. Again, I'll award 5 points for victory, 2 points for second place, and nothing for the loser. One little warning. I do hope our contestants haven't been out on the piste too much while practicing, as this challenge will require perfect timing and lightning reactions.
Okay, so the game is snowboarding on Val d'Isère. Anil's up first for the Redbridge Raiders. They came last in the first heat, so they've got everything to play for on this one. All right then, Anil, start your challenge! He's off
he goes.
Nice bit.
Snowboarding down. They've got to get through those gates. That's the most important thing. If they miss those gates, they get a 2-second penalty. And the number of gates they miss is shown in the top right-hand corner of the screen. by the blue figures. He's whipping in and out. He's only missed one gate so far. He's not wiped out. It's very difficult to wipe out on this.
Yes,
the secret is usually is in how fast you manage to wiggle your way down the course. If you wiggle too much, you lose time, you cut the snow. He's obviously pinning his chances on not getting too many penalties. No, he's missed two gates now.
Sean Seabrook of the Armchairs is up next. What's the SP on him, Dave?
Well, Sean claims to have completed Sonic 2 within 2 hours of having bought it, but who doesn't?
Well, let's hope it's a serious challenge for him. Sean, get yourself ready! Start your challenge!
Josh, he's off. He's off. He's got off to a good start. Nice bit.
James Bryan away.
Once again, he's going to wiggle in.
Carving nicely.
He doesn't want to miss his game.
Carving.
He's doing very, very nicely. Good very, very good. Nicely. I know he was quite worried about this challenge. He was practicing a lot in the practice room, but he's doing very, very nicely. He was taking everyone on the practice room, actually. He was doing very well. He seems confident. I think he's only hit two gates so far, which is good. He hasn't got away about too many penalties. Oh, he just scraped inside that gate just now. I thought he was going to catch it. He's doing very, very well. Oh, he just missed that one. That's three gates he's missed. But very good through the finish. See what his penalty points are.
Okay, Sean Seabrook scored 38.92. That's about 0.2 of a second faster than the Redbridge Raiders score. Azad is up next. He's playing for the Turbo Destructors. Let's see if he can do the business. Azad, start your challenge!
Yeah. Yeah, he's ready. He's off, because Azad. It's important to get off to a nice bit of acceleration at the start. If you go too fast, you lose it, however. Azad's doing very well on the side. He's hit no gates so far. He's doing very, very well. The secret could be not to hit the gates, and then you don't suffer the 2 second penalties later on when it tallies up. He still hasn't hit a gate. He's still doing very, very well, weaving from side to side. If he can keep his cool, he could be on for putting his team through. He's doing very, very well. He's hit no gates. The gates are getting closer together now. He's getting tough. That's extremely good. That's a perfect time. 34 seconds.
Azad scored 34 dead. Fantastic time. I think it's about time we went and checked out the scoreboard. The Raiders scored nought in the first round and nought in this round. That means they've got zilch. Second place is the Armchairs. They got two in the first round and two in this heat as well. That means they've got a massive four. And the Turbo Destructors are the team to beat with a massive 10 points. Yeah. Well done, Armchairs. Well done, Turbo Lot. Now, Colleen, team captain of the Redbridge Raiders, got blown out. You gutted?
Yeah, I am, actually. These two people are so sad, both of them. Well,
I'm not sad. It was very close, 0.2 seconds. What could I say?
Yeah, but your team captain didn't even get to play.
You're stupid, man. Play. I can play better with my eyes.
All right, we're done with that. All right, I'm afraid your standard's nowhere near high enough. We're going to have to get the caretaker to expel you from the academy. Yeah. Get out! Okay, in part two, we're going to have the Armchairs and the Turbo Destructors battling out for a place in the championship semi-finals. And if that's not good enough for you, we've got a celebrity challenge that's to die for. So keep it locked and don't go away. We'll be back soon. Welcome back. Well, it's time for our celebrity challenge, and they're waiting in the wings. So, please welcome, if you will, QPR's top scorer, Les Ferdinand, and Wimbledon soccer psycho, Vinnie Jones! Fans here tonight. So, Les, we all know Vinny's reputation. You're a bit intimidated by him.
Yeah, I am a little bit.
With his challenge, yeah? And Vinny, so do you play a lot of computer games yourself?
No, little girl's got a few computer games, you know, man. Just cost me a lot of money. I never get the
point. You're not meant to say that. All right, well, I think it's fairly obvious what kind of challenge these guys are going to be doing. But let's go over to the Games Master, find out exactly what it's going to be.
I am pleased to announce the first part of my very special Celebrity Soccer Championship. Tonight's contestants will face each other on the realistic football simulation FIFA soccer for the Mega Drive. I have selected Brazil and Holland for the first round. Whoever comes out on top of the two halves of end-to-end action qualifies for a chance to win my golden joystick in a fortnight. I want 110% from both my contestants.
So, Vinny and Les have taken their positions at the console. They're playing the first round of our FIFA Soccer Challenge. The winner of tonight's challenge is going to come back in 2 weeks' time for the final. Now, Dave, who's your favourite then?
I'm putting my money on Vinny Jones's tenacity for this one.
Yeah, I reckon you're just playing it safe, Dave. Anyway, let's see what happens. Okay, guys, start your challenge.
Let's Brazil kicking from right to left. The player with a star underneath him will be the player that the computer games player is actually controlling. When that star is lit up, that shows that that player has control of the ball.
Nice lob.
A little burst of speed. Lesbeth Brazil, that was a great shot. He just went wide. If you move the D-pad after you've taken a shot, you get a little bit of aftertouch, a little bit of curl. Sometimes that makes a difference with beating the keeper. Jones. That was a great goal, far side the area. Les actually had the better of the play. He got to Vinny. Vinny had the one chance and he took it. Get it out of the back to Vinny.
Nice break up, Phil.
Once again, Vinny got the game away. Well, that's just a long, hopeful shot. There's two competitors have got to get a little bit closer and choose their shots a little bit more carefully.
Into the field, another nice little chip.
Oh, that's a goal for Vinny Jones. Can he finish it? Vinny Jones. Vinny Jones was poaching, yeah. Buried it, lovely.
So nil.
There's Les with Brazil, got the kick off again. He's really going to have to go forward. That's the end of the first half. 2-0 to Vinny Jones.
2-0 to Vinny Jones and Holland. Players are ready.
Okay, Les has kicked off straight into Vinny again. Now Vinny's really brimming with confidence now. He's winning everything, surging forwards. Poor old Les, he's doing his best to pull something out of here. It's not working. Vinny Jones with a curling shot just past the upright. Les wants to get forward a bit now. He's got nothing to lose. He really wants to try rain
on
the
ball.
Les has a beautiful burst of speed. What a great save.
What a save from Vinny. Vinny was there
right
again.
The area. So you've got to pick your shot a little bit more carefully. Get a few strikers racing.
If you've only just joined us, the score's still 2-0 to Holland.
Once again,
Brazil are making a valiant effort. The crowd are going wild.
Let's have a nice long kick out from Les. Come on, Les, get it upfield.
Les is making strike, his man is there! Go on, Les!
Shot in! Oh!
Straight over the crossbar.
Over the crossbar. Now the keeper wants to kick it out. Now will Les master the kicking?
Bosh!
Sorry, that was Vinny's keeper. Will Vinny master the kick?
Les is all over, Vinny.
Les is really... Oh, that was dirty!
He's been making a break in the second half!
Vinny's
ball's there! No!
The keeper was nowhere.
They've won, that's it. It's the end of the second half. Holland win!
Holland win, 2-0.
So you're letting two goals in the first half there. Do you think it sort of blew it for you a bit?
Yeah, I think so. I think I'll have a word with our goalkeeper, Jan Stoke.
Yeah, you're blaming the goalkeeper, are you? Vinny, pleased with that result?
Yeah, I got the hang of the goalkeeper quite early.
Yeah, you certainly were. You were stopping them all over the place. It was a good challenge. Thank you very much. You're going to be coming back in a couple of weeks to play in the final of our FIFA Soccer Challenge, if you don't mind.
I'm sure you can.
Yeah, good one. All right, then. Let's have a big round of applause for Les Ferdinand and Vinny Jones. In a few moments' time, the Turbo Destructors and the Armchairs are going to be battling out for a place in our championship semis. So while they limber up, let's go over to the Games Master for the consultation zone.
Hello, and welcome to my clinic for gaming unfortunates. Who's first for some treatment?
Games Master, I can't get off level 6 of Aladdin on the Mega Drive. I keep falling off the rocks. Can you help me?
Funny you should say that. I don't think it's particularly hard to keep out the lava, but this should solve your problem. While playing the level, pause the game and press the following melodious combinations of buttons. A, B, B, A, A, B, B, A. If you've done this correctly, you will instantly be ferried to the end of the level and on to the next. Satisfied now?
Cheers, Games Master.
Next.
Games Master, I've heard there's a secret bonus room for Super Star Wars on the SNES. Do you know where it is?
I may be able to provide a little assistance to you. Halfway down the sand river, jump left from the ledge, and as you fall, keep holding down left. Magically, you will travel through the wall and find yourself in a secret room containing a host of bonuses, including a blaster power. It should be an easy matter to complete the level now.
Thanks, Games Master.
It was no trouble. Who's next?
Game Master, I need more money syndicate for Vega. Give it to me, please.
Well, as you ask so directly, I'll tell you directly. On the configure compass beam, enter your name as Cooper T. Now start the game and look at your bank balance. You have loads of money. You will also have access to all the game's array of weaponry, including the awesome Gauss gun. Happy blasting.
Nice one, big fella.
I think that's quite enough of my wisdom dispensed for one session. Happy bye.
Some useful hints and tips there from the games master in the consultation zone. Now, you've joined us at a crucial stage of tonight's show. These two teams are battling out for a place in the semi-final. There's no points here. Whichever team wins, they're the ones who are going to get through. So, team captains, have you chosen who's going to play?
Yeah, Camel's going to play for my team.
Yeah? So, Camel, you like the championships resting on your shoulders. You realise that?
Yeah.
You confident?
Yeah.
Yeah? No worries. Well, he's silent, but maybe he's deadly. Sean?
Yes, indeed.
Did that intimidate you at all?
Not in the slightest, unfortunately. We need our guy winding up as much as possible, because that's how he fights best.
That's right, and Christian's going to be playing for you, yeah?
Christian's going to be playing for us.
OK, let's go over to the Games Master, find out exactly what this challenge is going to be.
Tonight's beat-em-up is the globally renowned World Heroes 2 for the Neo Geo. I've selected the flamboyant characters J-Max and Captain Kidd for this challenge, whose special moves have a real bite and involve some skinny ball throwing. The first contestant to take two rounds off his opponent will be tonight's winner. Let the battle commence.
Okay, Chris and Calgit are in position. They're going to play three rounds of beat-em-up action on World Heroes 2. Dave, what's these two guys for, mate? Is it going to be a good one?
It's going to be a good one, because in our audition, Chris was the stronger fighter. He beat Mike Bison twice on Level 8 on Street Fighter 2, while Kaoji lost a round to a Level 8 blanker.
OK, so there should be a hot battle. OK, guys, start your challenge! There we go.
Well, I have to point out, Chris is going to be playing J-Max, the American football player, while Kaoji is actually Captain Kidd, Captain Kidd fighter.
He's boxing him in now.
What you should be looking out for is the energy bars at the top of the screen.
Yeah.
As they go down,
Kidd's going down fast.
The more the fighter's suffering. Oh, that was a sharp knuckle special move. That's Captain Kidd's special move called the sharp knuckles. He sends a shark-shaped energy bar, and that was very nice. J-Max hit back. This is a really
good one. Come on, J-Max, slogan for big hits at him.
That's lovely. That's his almost special down. Energy ball American football move. He's hurling it at
he's
Captain
hammering
Kidd.
It.
It's very, very close. And Captain Kidd's gone
Captain
down.
Captain Kidd bites the big one.
J-Max takes the first round.
First round to J-Max.
So J-Max is one up. That's Chris one up.
Chris
Captain
is one
Kidd's
up.
Got to win this one now. If he's going to stand a chance.
Come on, Captain. You can do it. Captain Kidd's making a nice comeback.
Captain Kidd uses some lovely
he's
combinations.
He's dropping him good.
He's not relying on special moves. Well, J-Max and Chris. Chris are firing at the people. Captain Kidd's done the business.
Nice that's quick round.
All. It's going to go
one
to the decider.
It's going all the way. Here we go for the third round.
It seems to it's be all J-Max's special moves against Captain Kidd.
Come on, Captain Kidd.
And combinations of punches and kicks. And once again, Captain Kidd today stunning J-Max. The struggle
J-Max
with Chris and
J-Max
are trying to rely on these special moves.
Special
moves
coming out all over the place. Go on, Kidd.
Firing at Captain Kidd. Captain Kidd's just getting in there and doing
go on,
the business with kicks and punches. And it's taking all the energy.
Oh,
J-Max is finished. That's the end for Chris. Captain Kidd's a winner.
The business. Nice one, well done. That means the Turbo Destructors are the first team through to the championship semi-finals. Let's go and meet the teams and see how happy or sad they really are. Here we go, guys. Well done. You're not coming, you two. Coming quickly. Well done. Chris, well, you won the first round, but things went a bit wrong after that.
Yeah.
So what happened?
Well, I don't know. Just lost concentration.
Momentary lapse of concentration. Let your team down.
Yeah.
Sean, I suppose you're not too happy with him, really,
well,
are you?
No, I'll have to deal with him later. No, he played well. He won the first round. Just didn't get any fireballs, main connection.
Well, they were a good team. What can you say? I mean, you were confident with your man, weren't you?
Yeah, I was very confident. I knew he was going to win. And I'm just about to say bad luck to them lot.
Oh, that's not saying it. Well, very sporting. Well done. Okay, these guys were good, but next week's guys are going to be even better. And if that's not enough for you, we've got John Barnes and Dennis Wise battling out on FIFA Soccer. Should be a good one. Bye.
Games Master, the official book by Dominic Diamond, is out now, price £6.99. And the monthly Games Master magazine is also out, price £1.95. Both can be found in the usual retail outlets.